Hello everyone, this is Reverend Dr. Rebecca Michael, and this is our little family dog, Josie, our little Phoenix Alive Christian Ministries Incorporated in Canada mascot. Now that's one of the ways we did to cope with being trauma survivors and to remember the loved ones that we lost in the process through our organization that we actually started. Now I didn't intend any of this, but the Lord brings glory through suffering, and I've done way more as well as my family. We've achieved very much more obeying and trusting and obeying God as led in the process over the last few decades, because that's how long it takes to go through the restoration and overcoming process. Just keep applying ourselves faithfully as the Lord leads us and by His Word. And eventually we get to the point where we end up starting our own ministry, and this is where we come into the overcoming part. But we can actually go out and give people tools and tips that we've learned in the process from learning to do more than the dog paddle that we might have had the serious coping tools and tips psychologically to get through this physically in every other way that there is to be a human being. And we learn to be champion swimmers, you know, because you don't really have a choice when you're thrown into these kind of waters. You know, it's like being in 3,700 feet of water, and so you have to learn to sink or swim, and you have to keep swimming. The option is to sink like a stone, you know. And we don't want to do that. We want to get through this trusting God to glorify even this not the situation, but to glorify us through the situation, and He will reunite and restore us fully and totally, including with our loved ones, in that they belong to the Lord. And you know what? They're in the best hands in the world. So now what we have to be concerned about is getting through this ourselves. And we're going to do that in the power of the Lord. And so He's about life. He's the King of life and the King of virtue. And as you can look around, you see in His creation how utterly generous He is. If you look out at the fireballs and, you know, you just look at the total generosity and don't take that for granted. You need every little thing you can get to feel grateful every day, because gratefulness leads also, that's one of the keys to overcoming. Gratefulness, thankfulness for what you do have, and just let that build in you, because that's life. It leads towards overcoming in life. It strengthens us. The Bible says that our joy is our strength. And so landmines, traps, and pitfalls is what I want to talk to you now about being a trauma survivor. And if I didn't say so, this is Reverend Dr. Rebecca Michael. I'm also a trauma survivor and overcomer and a Christian counselor, ordained Christian minister now, all as part of the end of the process that the Lord has brought me through the same things, giving you now tools and tips. And I've got quite the extensive background as well on the way through this process in mental health, both secular and Christian counseling. And so I'm here to impart some of what I know can give you in the way of support. We have a Facebook support group. If you want to Google search it over at Facebook, called Survivors of Suicide. And I'm Reverend Dr. Rebecca Michael. I'm one of the admins there. That's how you know you're in the right group. And we make these videos, including this one, with our Christian ministry. You just met our dog, our little mascot there, our family dog. Phoenix Alive Christian Ministry was quite literally born out of the ashes of the death, the trauma survivor, overcoming out of the ashes of my family, quite literally. And it had a domino suicide effect of death, and it just has a domino effect, which is in the process now of being canceled. That's the plans of the devil: canceled, destruction, canceled, by faith and obedience and overcoming, being restored and overcoming through the faith and obedience that I've learned by trust. Now, this isn't tyranny, this is trust. God is benevolent, He's a championer, He is not here to take away our power. That's the tyrant, that's the fake Satan, fake ministers, or the condemners, the shamers, all these kind of things. Yeah, they don't have any overcoming news, tools and tips for you in that area, not from God. The messenger may have to repent. They may be of God, but the message certainly isn't of God, because God shows us the way. Jesus is a carpenter, and so yeah, he's the bread of life. He gives us life. And so just as I said in the last one, seek, knock, and ask, and apply yourself diligently as you're shown. Allow the Lord to bring glory and to strengthen you line upon line, as it says in the Bible, and precept upon precept, following his truth. And because Satan's a liar, and so don't listen to any of his lies, his condemnation, his shame, his all that kind of stuff. But do listen to true repentance, which means that there may be things in you, there's things in all of us, let's put it that way, that we need to change and go the other way, do the exact opposite towards life, towards others, and learn love out of this, and learn, And so the landmines, traps, and pitfalls, there are two ways you can go about this. You can either use avoidance behaviors, or you can face it. Now, if you're going to face it, you need support. And so if you want to look at the last video I did, I talk about support, the importance of support. You may have to cut off some people that right now are not supportive or helpful. If you read the account of Job, you see he had three friends that were totally, except for the grace of God and the grace of Job, they would have been destroyed by God himself, because they were telling him all the wrong stuff. They were giving him condemning messages, not messages to help him through this, to be restored and overcome, which is what God wants for his people. And he wants it for all of us. He wants people to be saved. And so if you just apply yourself, as I said in that last one, you'll overcome. And so we do lots of videos on health and fitness, and Christian counseling, mental health tools and tips that we impart freely as part of our ministry. JD Leadership Series, What Would Jesus Do? To avoid the traps, for example, avoid tunneling type of thinking. We have to change our thinking. We ought to cast down every high thought that we know isn't of God, for such a shame and condemnation, for example, and hang on to the good, and to apply ourselves in the ways that God says that we are to repent, which just means turning away from what's not true towards what is true, whether we feel like it or not, because that the truth is objective, it's not subjective. So you know what? It leads to life to listen to truth, ultimately. And so to avoid avoidance behaviors and face this with supportive people, even if it means that you have to cut certain people off for now until you get stronger and you know where you're going and what you're doing, you get through those waters yourself, because you've got to survive this to be able to go back and help others, because typically this is a high call. And how are you going to be able to do your calling if you don't get through it yourself? So you need to get with supportive people. That's very important, that know what they're doing. So find the kind of suffering or survivor that you are, and go towards those support groups. We have a suicide survivor support group, for example, over at Facebook, and you can start your own once you get into the overcoming. But you need to come into forgiveness, which is the final, and acceptance, because that's the letting go part. I'm just checking the time here. And so avoid tunneling. Be careful about triggers, things that remind you of the trauma. And, it's better to be proactive and to know these things ahead of time. What triggers you? Depressions and grief reactions, anger, stuff like that. And, get help with those. Also, relapse. Be careful about relapse, because we may recover, but then we can relapse back on holidays and of the suicidal death of a loved one, or a murder, or a violence, various triggers that may trigger that. And try to stay in the overcoming, forgiving, and acceptance stage, and don't go for revenge. Allow that. God says he is the avenger. And so we don't know the whole story. We don't know the big picture. God does, though. He knows how to deal with this one. And so give that to God. Let him avenge it. For us, we need to forgive and let go in order to be separated from the trauma. And also avoid self-pity, understanding that real compassion, pity is a counterfeit. Remember, there's counterfeit for everything with the devil. Real compassion involves overcoming. People want you to be championed through, to be a repairer in breach of walls. And so Isaiah 61, read that one. Forgive and move on. God will give you beauty for ashes. And I'll come right back to the final one of the series, which is about overcoming. God bless you.